Good morning, students. Today we are going to continue with the same poem we started yesterday, A Legend of the Northland. So as I told you already that this poem is a ballad. Okay, the qualities of the ballad I told you yesterday, so we have done even 1.5 page. So then she took a tiny scrap of dough and rolled it flat and baked it thin as wafer. But she couldn't part with that. So what happened? So that little woman who was asked by Saint Peter to give him a cake. That woman, when she wanted to give him a cake, she tried to bake a cake. She made cake many a times, but each time the cake which she made, she thought it was too large to be given to the saint. So finally she took a very small scrap of dough and rolled it flat, which looked like a wafer. So even then she didn't want to give that to the saint. For she said, my cakes that seem too small when I eat them myself. So when she eats the cake, when she eats those cakes, then she finds them too small and yet too large to give away. But when she gives them over, then she finds those cakes too large. So the point is, this is the trait of the selfish people who find the things to be too big when they want to give it to somebody. Okay, but when it comes to themselves, they find the things to be too less or too little. So it is being selfish. Then good Saint Peter grew angry, for he was hungry and faint. And surely such a woman was enough to provoke a saint. So during this time, because already Saint Peter was very hungry and he was already very tired, and the saints, you know, they don't have much time to stay at one place for a long time. So he became impatient. He became very annoyed because already he was feeling weak and hungry. And moreover, this kind of woman was enough. This kind of woman who was so greedy and selfish, that kind of woman was enough to make this kind of saint become angry. Okay, so surely such a woman, what such a woman? The woman who was so greedy and selfish. So that selfish and greedy woman was enough to provoke, to make the saint angry. And he said, you are far too selfish to dwell in the human form, to have both food and shelter and fire to keep you warm. So he told her that you kind of selfish person, you know, should not enjoy the human form. You must not be that, like, you don't deserve to be called as human being. So selfish, greedy people should not be called as human beings. They don't have the right, they don't deserve to be given the human form. So you don't deserve to be given food, shelter, and even fire to keep yourself warm. Means you are not that good that you should be given all the comforts of a good life, that is food, shelter, and even fire. Now you shall build as the birds do and shall get your scanty food and buy boring and boring and boring all day in the hard, dry wood. So he told her, like, now, because you are very selfish, you're very greedy. So you don't deserve to be given all those comforts which a human being deserves. The comfort of food, the comfort of shelter, the comfort of being warm with fire. So instead of getting all these kinds of comforts, now you will be building your own home like the birds. You will be getting that food which is very less. And moreover, that food will not be available to you without making efforts. You'll have to make efforts to get that little food. So how will you be making efforts? You will be piercing that wood hard and hard. So boring is piercing through the wood, pecking at the wood. So that Saint Peter, you know, he cursed her. So the Saint Peter, he was very annoyed and he cursed this woman that she didn't deserve to be called as a human being. She didn't deserve to enjoy the comforts of a human being. because she was very selfish, so she will have to undergo the changes. So the way birds build their own nest, she will also have to build her own home, thereby making in a lot of efforts. So what kind of efforts she would be making? As a bird, she would be piercing deep into the... Yes, Kriti, what is the meaning of boring? What's the meaning of B-O-R-I-N-G, boring? Unmute yourself. Kriti, raise hand. Kriti, what's the meaning of B-O-R-I-N-G? Come on. Kriti. Okay, so boring means, Jia?
Ma'am, pecking.
Yes, beta, hanji. Pecking or piercing. P-I-E-R-C-I-N-G. So she will, like a bird, she would be piercing or pecking at the wood to either make her nest or to get that little food. And she would be doing this activity of boring throughout the day in the dry wood. Then up she went through the chimney, never speaking a word, and out of the top flew a woodpecker, for she was changed to a bird. So the moment Saint Peter cursed the woman, instantly that woman changed into a bird. That very minute, she went through the chimney and she didn't utter a single word. Why didn't she utter a single word? Basically, she didn't get the chance to speak anything. Got it? So sometimes when you commit a mistake, sometimes there is not even a chance to say sorry. Okay? So before doing the wrong, we must always realize like what might be the outcome of our bad action. So this woman didn't even get the chance to say sorry. She didn't even get the chance to redo something good. So without speaking anything, she went through the chimney, and actually by that time she had been transformed into the bird, and she came out of the chimney like as a woodpecker, because she had been transformed to a bird. She had a scarlet cap on her head. What is the meaning of scarlet, Lavanya? Unmute yourself, 37 roll number. Lavanya. Lavanya, 37 roll number. Okay, Deepali, roll number 8.
Yes, ma'am.
What's the meaning of scarlet?
Red colored.
Yeah, that's it. Well done. So she had a scarlet cap on her head, and that was left the same. But all the rest of her clothes were burned black as a coal in the flame. So she, the only thing which she had been able to retain, which she had earlier, that was her red cap. So that red cap remained on her head. So earlier also she might be having a red cap, and that red cap was there on her head as woodpecker also. And the rest of the clothes, they all burnt and they changed into black color. So black as a coal. So all her clothes changed into black color, as if it was as, because they were as black as coal, simile. So the poetic device here is simply black as a coal in the flame. So her all other clothes which she was wearing, they were changed into black color, because the clothes which she was wearing, they were burnt in the flame. And every country schoolboy, has seen her in the wood. So every country schoolboy, so all the children, those who live in that countryside, they have seen that her in the wood. Wood is a forest. Where she lives in the trees till this very day, boring and boring for food. So everybody has seen her. So all the children, those who live in that countryside, they have seen her in the woods or in the forest. And she lives in the trees all the very day. And throughout the day, she is, you know, working hard to make her nest. And how does she work hard? She keeps on piercing or pecking at the wood throughout the day. And she gets very less to eat. Right? So children, this is how this poem ends, with the message that if we do something wrong, if we do wrong, then we'll get the wrong. Okay? So greed is a curse. Instead of becoming greedy and selfish, we must try to be generous as well as selfless. Only then we'll be able to serve the humanity. Only then we would deserve to be called as human being. Okay, the basic qualities of a human being are to be generous, kind, and selfless. Even the animals can be selfish. Even the animals can be greedy. Then we human beings cannot be like that. If we are, we don't deserve to be the human beings. So this poem, with a story within and a message in the end, turns out to be a ballad. And it's a legend. The ballad tells us about a legend. And legend is a story, which is an ancient tale. Legend is an old tale, ancient tale, which is being told from generation to generation. And this legend may not be real. This legend might not have been actually true. But yes, there is a message behind it. So that message makes the legend become unique and worth telling. Right? So here the writer is explaining, ballad is a song narrating a story in short stanzas. Ballads are a part of folk culture or popular culture and are passed on orally from one generation to next. The legend of Northland is a ballad. So who was Saint Peter? Saint Peter was an apostle of Christ. So now here are the questions. We'll be discussing them right now. So all of you, be ready to answer the questions. Right? There is no need to raise hand. I can ask anyone to give the answers. And when you give answer, then your videos must be turned on. Right? Your videos must be turned on when you give the answer. And try to give the answers honestly. Okay? So let us first read the questions. What did Saint Peter ask the old lady for? Yes, what did Saint Peter ask the old lady for? And what was the lady's reaction? Let's ask somebody. Okay, Gurupal, give the answer.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, brother. Good morning. Yes, first question.
Good morning, ma'am.
Yes, first question.
Then the Saint Peter asked the old lady to give him some food as he was walking for so long, and the lady's reaction was.
Yes, come on, children. Okay, now we can ask the same question from 9C, Raghav. Raghav, unmute yourself. Raghav, Anshya, note down the names who are not responding. Okay, Garima. Yes, Garima. Speak up. Ansha, you might be noting down the names, those who are not responding. Okay, Gurshan Singh.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, but our first question. What did Saint Peter ask the old lady for? Yes. It's very easy. Saint Peter asked the old lady for some thing to eat. He asked the old lady for a piece of cake. He asked the old lady for a piece of cake because at that time she was baking cake. So the Saint Peter who was very weak, who was very tired and hungry because he had been walking around the world. He had been traveling around the world to preach people. He was very hungry and tired. And by the time he was going by that side, he happened to pass by the cottage where that little lady lived. At that time, she was baking cakes. And the Saint Peter asked her to give him a piece of cake because he was very tired and hungry, right? And it was getting dark. So what was lady's reaction? So what was the lady's reaction to what Saint Peter asked for? So the lady, when she was already baking cakes. So when she was asked for a piece of cake, she started baking. She started baking the least cake, the cake which was too small in size. Okay, but whenever she wanted to give it to him, she found it too large. So eventually she was not able to part with the smallest piece of cake as well. How did he punish her? How did he punish her? He punished her by cursing her. Okay, those who are raising hand, let me see. Okay. Yes, Manyavit, unmute yourself. Yes, Manyavit, unmute yourself.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. Yes, second question, beta. How did he punish her?
He punished her by giving a curse and making her a woodpecker.
Yeah, you can explain it also. Okay, otherwise it's okay. He punished her by cursing her. By giving her a curse. He told her that because she did not deserve to be called a human being, because she lacked the basic virtues of selflessness and generosity, so she cursed her that she would become a woodpecker who would be building her own nest, thereby working very hard throughout the day. And moreover, she would be getting very less food to eat. Okay, you'll be explaining all this. How did he punish her? Next question is, how does the woodpecker get her food? Yes. How did the woodpecker get her food? Yes, Gaurav. Gaurav.
Yes, ma'am. When the woodpecker needs to bore all day in the hard dry wood to get itself some food.
Yes, the woodpecker bores or pecks at the wood throughout the day. You know, woodpecker gets scanty food. First of all, you can mention it gets very less food after after long days pecking at the wood. Okay, next question is, do you think that the old lady would have been so ungenerous? Do you think that she would have been so ungenerous if she had known who Saint Peter really was? What would she have done then? That's a good question. So if the little woman had known that who this Saint Peter was, then would she have been so ungenerous even then? Garima, yes.
She
Yes, Garima. Garima is not there, I guess. Anshya, yes.
Would not have been so ungenerous if she had known who Saint Peter really was. As she was very greedy, she would have given him large cakes and welcomed him into her house to please him and get his blessings.
Yeah. So what would she have done then? It's okay. So if the old lady had known that the Saint Peter was an apostle of Christ, she would not have been so ungenerous. She would have definitely made big and large cakes for him and would have satisfied him. Okay, so she would have given him a big piece and would have satisfied him and would have tried to take his blessings, right? So do you think that the old lady would have been, this we have done, is this a true story? Which part of the story or of the poem you feel is the most important? So do you think it's a true story? Kriti, 9C. Kriti. Raghav. Arshdeep Kaur.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. Which question do you want to answer?
Ma'am, sixth question.
Yes. No, yeah.
No, it's not a true story. The part of the poem which tells us that when does something wrong is always punished. That part of the story is the most important, as it is the moral of the story.
It's okay, yes. So you can say, is this a true story? No, I don't think it's a true story, because I don't think it actually a saint Peter kind of person might curse a woman to become a bird like this. And moreover, the most important segment of this poem is the last part, where that woman was turned into a woodpecker, because that was where the moral of the poem emerges. That's it, correct. What is a legend? Why is this poem called a legend? This answer we have discussed many a times. So who will give answer? What is a legend? Come on, raise hand, those who know. Yes, Lavanya.
Ma'am, a legend is a story from ancient times about people and events. The title of the poem tells that it is a legend, as the poet himself says that I don't believe it is true.
Yeah, it's okay. So what's a legend? Legend is an old or ancient story which is told to the next generation by one generation. It goes on from one generation to another, and it has a moral. That's the biggest quality of a legend, that it must have a moral. So what would you say? Legend is an ancient story told from one generation to another, and it has a moral. So why is this poem called a legend? Because it's an old tale, and moreover, the poet also says this, that he doesn't think it's true, but he's going to tell it to us because it has a moral within it, right? So write a story of a legend of the Northland in about 10 sentences. So you people do this in your own words. Okay. So now we have done this, finished this poem. Tomorrow is Saturday, and on Saturday will be the test of this poem as well as the previous chapter. What was that chapter?